Hey, this is Andrew Brown from Exam Pro, and we are taking a look here at Google Cloud's solution pillars, and there's seven in total here, and there's a lot of text, so let's work our way through it. So the first is infrastructure modernization, so replacing legacy hardware and software systems with cloud solutions allows organizations to adopt hybrid architectures and have more infrastructure mobility, choosing a mix of best cloud service provider offerings for their organizational use case. So in this case, if we're talking about hybrid architectures, one service that we could utilize would be Anthos, and this allows you to manage compute from both on-premise and public cloud in a single unified interface. Moving on to business applications platform portfolio. So the backbone of CSPs are built on top of robust, well-documented APIs standardized across all offered cloud services. Organizations can focus on the configuration and interconnections of various systems instead of having to build their own systems. So what are they talking about here? We're talking about Cloud SDK, Cloud API, Cloud CLI, and the Google Cloud documentation. For number three, we have application modernization. So building web applications on top of cloud services allows organizations to globally deliver and rapidly iterate faster than ever before. CSPs offer automated deployment pipelines, AI-powered code reviews, easy staging and testing of new features, the ability to test in production, rollback changes. Apps are more durable and can remain available when facing catastrophic regional failure. So one thing that makes it really easy to build out very robust web apps is if you're able to migrate your web app over to App Engine, because it just takes care of a lot of the stuff for you. And all you got to do is upload your code and do some configuration, make some choices, but more or less, it makes it very highly durable, available, and scalable. Then you have database and storage solutions. So most companies can tolerate losing application code. You can always write. Losing data is not something you can recover. Cloud service providers have guaranteed SLAs of data durability, as well as the ability to easily migrate and secure your data. So in this case, if we're looking at cloud storage, which is on the storage or file side side of the scenario here, it can store files and documents as objects, and its availability is 99.5%, and they have it's SLA backed. Okay. And the way they do that is that they're replicating your data across multiple zones. So if a zone fails, it'll just recover cover files from another zone, and it does that automatically for you. For number five, we have smart analytics. So when you store data on cloud service providers, you can tap into big data and business intelligence cloud offerings assisted by AI to help you analyze your data. So for Google, there's Looker, and this is data exploration discovery business intelligence platform acquired by Google, and it is now part of GCP. Then you have artificial intelligence. So AI, deep learning, ML are specialized domains that traditionally required scarce and expensive subject matter experts. Cloud is commoditizing, simplifying AI knowledge while driving costs lower for adoption. So there's a lot of tools here that Google has, but the primary ones is Vertex AI. This is a unified platform for AI, ML, deep learning, auto ML. They have their own deep learning framework they've developed. It's really easy to use. This is my most favorite framework, and this is the one I always use. Then we have security. So cloud services by default have strong mechanisms built in for security, governance, compliance. CSPs are continually developing new and innovative security offerings, not just at a service per service level, but to analyze, recommend, and remediate at the project and organization level. You can easily and quickly audit and apply security controls to become compliant in a fraction of the time than on an on-premise solution. And so things you get when you're working the cloud, IAM. I mean, if you're using private cloud, I suppose you'd get that with OpenStack, but IAM, so role-based access controls and user management. One that I really like that Google has is BeyondCorp. It's a zero trust model framework. Then there's the Security Command Center. So it's a centralized, it centralizes visibility and control for security and stuff, for misconfigurations. But there's a lot more there, but this is just to kind of help you ground each of these pillars into something practical, okay?